Hi children, good morning. Which topic we are learning children? Good, we are learning about our second chapter. What is our second chapter?
Map,
our friend and guide. Yes or no? This is our second chapter. Tell me, what is our second chapter name?
Map, our friend and guide.
Very good. This is our second chapter. Tell me children, in the previous class, what we discussed? We discussed about different types of maps and the differences between a map and globe. Yes or no? Good. Did you write the previous class homework? Okay, very good. So children, today in this class, we are going to learn about directions on a map. What children?
Directions on a map.
Okay, na? Tell me children, do you know the directions? How many directions are there? Good. Four directions. Yes or no? Tell me, what are they? North, south, east and west. These are the four directions. Yes or no? Can you tell me children, you know how to find these four directions? It means which direction is north and which direction is the south? Where is the north direction? Where is the south direction? You know? Don't know. Yes or no? So today in this class, I am going to tell you how to find these four directions easily. Okay, na children? Listen carefully. Okay, na? It is very easy to find out these four directions. Okay, na? Okay. Take your textbooks, children. Open the page number 231. Okay, na? Here is, you can see directions on a map. How to find these four directions on a map? You can see easily in this class. Okay, na? Look at the paragraph, children. Listen carefully. There are four main directions, namely north, south, east and west. It is easy to find these directions. Stand facing the sun in the morning, you face the east, and your back is towards the west. Your right hand points to the south and your left hand points to the north. Similarly, stand facing a map hanging on a wall. The top of the map shows north and the bottom shows south. Your right hand side shows east and your left hand side shows west. Once the four directions are known, it is easy to identify the other four subdirections. Between the north and the west lies the northwest. Between the north and the east lies the northeast. Between the south and the west lies southwest. Between the south and the east lies the southeast. Every map all over the world follows this uniform pattern of naming and locating directions. There are four main directions. Tell me children, what are they? Look at the board. These are the four main directions. One is north, south, east and west. These are the four main directions. So children, now how to find these four main directions? It means which side is north and which side is south, which side is east. How can we find? It is easy to find these four directions. See, first children, in the morning, first of all, you have to stand facing the sun in the morning. It means keep your face, which side is the sun is rising? your face is the east side. Okay, now the children, your back. Your back is west direction. Your back is there in the west direction. And children, your right hand is in the north direction. Your right hand is in the north direction. And your left hand is in the south direction. Okay, now like this, we can find these four directions easily. Yes or no? First, standing face is east. Standing in front of the sun, your face is the east side, and you are towards west. Your right hand showing the north, and your left hand is showing the south. Okay, now like this, you can find out these four main directions. So this is easy. Then, how do we find these four directions on a map? Okay, now let's see how to find these north, south, east, west four directions on a map. Okay, now the map. Now we are going to find out these four directions. Which side is north and which side is south on a map? Okay, now.
South and east,
we can see southeast subdirection. then only we will get the another sub-directions. Okay, na? Tell me once again, I am asking for you how to find out this. First, make four directions on a map. First, what you have to do, children? First, stand in front of the map. First, stand in front of the map. Top of the map, which direction? Tell me. Good. North. Bottom of the map, which direction? Below the map. South. Right side of the map. Good. East direction. And the west side. And the left side. Good. West direction. These are the four directions. If you know, then you can easily identify the remaining sub directions. Okay, na? Every map follows this pattern only. Directions is over. Now scale on a map. Scale on a map. Look at the paragraph, children. Every map has to show how to measure the distance between two places shown on it. This scale helps us to study the map in a better way. For this, a scale is given in a corner of the map. For example, if the scale says 1 centimeter is equal to 100 kilometers, it means 1 centimeter on the map is equal to 100 kilometers on the ground. Okay, now look, children, this is a scale on the map. These two also scales on the map. There is another way to show the scale of a map. This is called line of scale. A line drawn at the corner of a map is divided into equal parts. Look at the diagram given below. Okay, now turn the page. A is the starting point. It starts for 0. The distance between two points is shown as 100 kilometers. So, the distance from A to B on the map is equal to 100 kilometers on the ground. The distance from A to C is 200 kilometers. Right? The distance from A to D is 300 kilometers and so on. Thus, with the help of this scale, we can measure the actual ground distance between two places. Okay, my children? Now, we are going to learn about the scale on a map. You can take any map, children. Every map consists of scale at the corner of a map. You can see the scale at the corner of a map. You can see, what is the use of this scale on a map, children? This scale is showing us, with the help of this scale, we can measure the distance between the two places. What we measure, children? We can measure distance between two places. It is very, very important. What is the use of this scale? With the help of this scale, we can measure the distance. The distance between two places. For example, you can take our India map. Hyderabad to Adilabad and Delhi to Mumbai, Kolkata to Chennai. So we want to know
This is your homework, children. Write down in your notebook.